Bird Troop 7's like a vampire. They're different, no?
Look who finally made it. Thought you'd never find me, did you, sweetheart? I've gotten good at knowing when I'm wanted. Ah, so you're who I'm waiting on. Someone must have faith in you, Cupcake. That, or they want you out of the picture. Interesting choice either way. Nasty dude? Hey. I may not be a looker, kid, but you better start showing some respect, because I could squash you like a freaking bug if my panties get all bunched up. You got it? Aw, shit, I'm Alcavian. And you ran into Nox, too? You guys must have had quite a conversation. Not a working brain cell between the two of you. Oh, well. The one and only. But don't bother with the introductions, fledgling. I know who you are. News travels down the kindred grapevine like wildfire. And that courtroom spat between LaCroix and Nines Rodriguez is a juicy little morsel. And you in the middle. How interesting. Oh, you did you? Well, I wasn't worried. So why did you need to find me? What did you need? Oh, never mind. The warehouse, though. I've been watching the place. The Sabbat has a bunch of low-life humans working day and night to move stuff through there. There's some major staging going on. The Sabbat. Jeez, you are green. It's like this. We're all monsters, like it or not. I'm not gonna say the Sabbat are the evil vampires, because none of us are the good guys here. But the Sabbat, they glorify their monstrous nature. They refuse to hide it, and go out of their way to show it. They're also brainless and reckless. They have a life expectancy of a vampire fruit fly. As far as I can tell, the humans seem to know the score from the way they've been talking. I think most of them have aspirations of joining the next graduating class of shovelheads. Ugh, losers. Yeah, the Sabbat like everyone to know just who they're dealing with. So if you get in there and have to bust a few heads, don't feel bad. Think of it as upholding the masquerade. Yes, I can. Just tell me when you're ready, and we'll leave. Once you're there, however, you're on your own. You'll have to get into the place and plant the explosives in the middle office to take the whole structure down.
Thank you. Yo, what the fuck is going on here tonight? Fox is all in everyone's face and shit.
Didn't you hear? A new shipment came in. Some pretty serious hardware.
Yeah, I heard. But what the fuck? We get that kind of shit in here all the time. What's so different about tonight?
I don't know. Marcus is tense as a motherfucker. Maybe you heard something.
Like what?
Like, I don't know, but keep your fucking eyes open. And someone better tell those clowns in the freight house to quit playing cards before Marcus comes out and starts peeling fucking caps, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah. Yeah, I hear you.
Freeze! Your handiwork, I presume? You're new to this life, aren't you? I'd wager you haven't insulted some of the older ones yet. But this is a city of opportunity. I see my reputation, for once, does not precede me. My name is Beckett. I haven't been following you, per se. We've just coincidentally been at the same places at the same time, for different reasons. So sorry if I unnerved you. Tell me, have you by chance seen or felt anything strange since your embrace? A ghost? Quite ordinary. I generally pay wraiths no mind. All but a few are willing to give up their secrets. Thin bloods, they're a fascination of mine. They are considered a weaker, more human-like kindred, hence the name, Thin Blood. But they are sired same as any of us. I've heard a large concentration of them live in this city. They're one of the reasons I'm in Los Angeles. Something to look forward to, eh? Most of my contacts here report sensing something unusual in the night air, like a sense of dread or pressure. But I'm not a native to these parts, so I can't tell if it's irregular. And since you're still fresh, perhaps you're not attuned to it. Pleasure meeting your acquaintance, but there are rumblings for me to discredit. We shall, I'm certain, meet again. Or never again. Good night, young one. And be careful. You're very likely being hunted by the Sabbat.
Nice work, Cupcake. I felt that explosion a mile away. It's all over the news, too. Man, there's gonna be some pissed off Sabbat just howling for blood tonight. Beckett? Well, I know of him. Why? No kidding. Huh. Must be something major happening if he's in town. Beckett is a historian of sorts. He's unearthed more vampire lore than anyone. Well, that's all Beckett does. Seek the truth behind our condition. What do you need? Those murders are definitely the work of Kindred. Probably some caitiff getting revenge on everyone who made fun of him in high school. Once the sheriff tracks this guy down, they're gonna make one hell of an example of him. Pretty close to the mark. Caitiff are just kind of riffraff vampires who don't know anything about vampire society, don't know their clan, mutt vampires. What I suspect you were perilously close to becoming if LaCroix hadn't intervened. You said it. Theory goes that the farther down the bloodline you are from Cain, the weaker the blood is. So if you're, say, fifth generation, the blood is strong. If you're 15th generation, you barely qualify as a vampire. A thin blood. Long shadow. Yeah, I see what you're saying. You Malkavians and your damned insight. Most fledglings don't know anything about Gehenna. You don't know the half of it, kid. Gehenna, the day we all die. When our sleeping forefathers rise and bring about the end of the world, many believe we're living in the final nights. Yep, that's him. Cain, the biblical brother killer, father of all vampires. Like what? Clans are just bloodlines, you know. A common root shared and passed on from sire to child. Malkavians are, interesting. There's something to them. Learning to sort the wisdom from the bullshit can be some work, and, not all of them are worth listening to, but, they're all good fun, if you ask me. Janice's daughter? What the... Oh, Janice. The two-faced god? You mean Therese Vorman. Oh man, you Malkavians are really messed up. Anyway, that was just silly vampire politicking, fledgling. No more. You get used to that kind of thing. I had my suspicions. What an interesting specimen. But a pain in my dead ass, for sure. Of course it did. As if vampires and women both weren't insecure enough. Get them together in one Malkavian body, and look what happens. Yeah, no kidding. Now that the Camarilla's moved into L.A., Therese wants the title of Prince of Santa Monica. I guess she saw me as a threat. Funny thing is, I could care less. I wouldn't want to be the Prince of Terre Haute. I leave that headache to the Ventru. Besides, there's only like 4 vampires in all of Santa Monica. Some kingdom. Like what? Sure. Jester. You call him LaCroix a jester? You duh, better watch that, Fletchling. Anyway, what am I gonna say? He's the boss now. Sure. The Nosferatu are damn good at what we do. No one even argues that. If you need to know, if you want it found, you come to us. We're indispensable. Not a bad place to be in the afterlife. The Nosferatu stick together, pool resources. We have more going on than anyone could guess at. Our web blankets the night. I'm loyal to the clan, loyal to my primogen, and therefore, loyal to the Camarilla. The Nosferatu are the eyes and ears of the Camarilla, so they take care of us. They value our services, or, don't want to be on our bad side. Either way, no one bothers us.
Let's drain it. Let's take it and leave it out for the sunrise.
We're going to have a lot of fun with this one. Think you could blow up our warehouse and get away with it? Lick.
Let's pull out its eyes and its tongue and its teeth.
I want its teeth.
Camarilla, fuck! all use a little entertainment. Those of you sitting in the first few rows will get wet. Son of a bitch!
Leave.
There's three of us, Rodriguez.
Yeah. Three of us.
What are you gonna do? Shoot us?
This ain't over. We'll find you. You too, Rodriguez. You're both dead. Nobody messes with a Sabbat and lives.
Keep moving. Trouble sure seems to like you. Good effort. Execution needs a little work. You look like shit. Name's Nines. Same thing that happens to a lot of anarchs, Malk. But you already know that somehow, don't you? Should have been more careful, newbie. This ain't the burbs. Kid, I got things to deal with. Why don't you pay me a visit at the last round tonight? I don't know what you've heard so far, but it's time you heard the real story. This is a mean existence. Stay out of trouble, kid.
Snack cake? What are you doing here? I mean, I gotta admit, I'm a little flattered if you're stalking me, but, anyhow, you see where your little security muffins ended up? Night shift lobby sergeant, huh? Hey, stick with me, because I'm going straight to the top, baby. I'd love to buzz you up, but according to Building Security Protocol 916, I'm gonna have to verify you're supposed to be here before I can open the elevator. I hate to be a Louis Law, but I'm new here, and you don't get a second chance like this every day. Okay then. Mr. LaCroix, he told me to expect someone fitting your description sometime tonight. You go right on up. You have a good power meeting, or whatever it is you types do up there. Do you need any security? Well, you just ring the front desk and ask for Officer Chunk. That's me, in case you were wondering. Ah, yeah, I get that all the time. The name goes back to my football days. My fantasy football days at the station. Stationarium. That was this office supply outlet mall I used to watch. Hey, you kids! No skating in the parking lot! That was me.
There you are. I was informed of your presence in the building. Since you're here, I'll take the liberty of assuming you've destroyed the warehouse. This is correct, yes? Most excellent. I had no doubt you'd prove my decision a prudent one. I trust you encountered no impediments to your progress on account of my personnel. Oh? Then I'll see that he's suitably punished. Nonetheless, you've triumphed. My commendations. You've done well, circumstances being what they were. I will admit, not many in your position would have overcome such a trial. But don't misunderstand me. It was no fool's errand. You may yet prove to be a genuine asset. It's a bit disturbing the lack of talent within this organization as of late. Tell me, what would you say to doing a bit of reconnaissance for me? Excellent. Were you by chance in the military at all? I was an officer myself, actually, in Napoleon's ranks. There have been whispers, rumors spreading around the kindred community concerning the Elizabeth Dane, the cargo ship that was towed into port recently. Have you heard of it? The police are investigating the Dane as we speak. Even the Nosferatu have little information on what's been found. However, the reason the ship has caused such speculation is because it was transporting an object called the Ankaran sarcophagus. Now, I'm not one to predicate a decision based on conjecture, so what I need is fact. And more importantly, I need evidence that the occurrences on the Dane were not supernatural in nature, and in no way relate to this Ankaran sarcophagus. You have three objectives. One, I want you to examine the sarcophagus for anything unusual. You may sense something peculiar about the sarcophagus. In fact, many kindred in the city have reported an uneasiness in the air since the Dane's arrival. Do not, under any circumstances, open the Ankaran sarcophagus. Secondly, the police have begun their investigation. Find out what they have concluded thus far. Thirdly, take the cargo manifest for the ship. I want to find out what else it was carrying. The last thing we want is police aware of our existence, so be careful what you do in front of them. And unlike the warehouse, you cannot wholesale slaughter a ship full of lawmen without consequences. Is this understood? Good. Oh, and it has come to my attention that you had an encounter with Nines Rodriguez earlier. The man so does love to throw that cretinous charm of his brashly about. What exactly did Mr. Rodriguez say? I see. Then, you should go humor the by-the-numbers rhetoric he's so desperately aching to spew. Oh, please, before the chance of fascist oppressor from that dive of theirs clog the air and choke the local kine. Give the Anarch community my regards.
Yeah, you go right on up and see Mr. LaCroix.
Ah, let's see what we got on good old camera 3. Oh, well, hello there. I've been thinking about you. Oh, yeah. I want to lick you all over. Then make my way down to your creamy center and... What the... Get your hands off my Bavarian cream! Get your hands off that!
Thank you. Well, if it ain't the talk of the town, poster child for Camarilla Benevolence. What does the prince have his little bitch doing today? Yes? What the hell did you say? You're about Kate, right? You double screwed. Crazy as hell and the prince's bitch. The pawns in? That shit is creepy. Wait here. My name is Skelton. I do my part to keep California a free state for the animals. But Camarilla just ain't necessary. Their rules is just common sense shit. Masquerade. Sure, it makes sense. Like the Ten Commandments. You know the Ten Commandments, don't you? Yeah. Steal, thou shalt not kill. Sounds good, but you and me both know that shit don't always fly. What if some society like the Camarilla comes along and just up and kills you if you break one damn command? See, we weren't meant to live like that. And I followed some of those fools for 3 years in Vietnam. But it wasn't until after the embrace that I understood real oppression. Anarchs, we are the only ticket to free living in the afterlife. You've got to understand, Kendrick. You're carrying a 6,000-year curse in your blood. No matter how powerful it makes you feel, that blood is a tangle of chains that's gonna leave you bound in servitude the rest of your existence. Your elders command the blood, they control the blood, and the blood listens. You'll never even hear their call, but the blood will, and it'll make you obey. That shit stretches all the way back to Cain. Nothing you can do. Some ancient sleeping in a tomb half a world away has a bad dream, and you gon' feel that shit. Hey, man. Father of all vampires. Killed his brother Abel and was cursed by God to walk eternity feeding on the blood of his children. Some heavy shit, sister. Keep your voice down. Is Cain real? I don't know. Not sure who wants. Point is, with this curse pulling your strings, you really want to sign away your right to fight by joining the Camarilla? I don't need to bare my fangs to feel good about myself. The Masquerade is a fruity Camarilla lady. Other than that, I ain't got no problem with it. Live and let live. We got enough to worry about. You know, speaking of the Masquerade, I just thought of something you might be able to help us out with. There's this girl who's been making a lot of noise lately. She's a real pain in the ass. She's a ghoul of this one Toreador creep who disappeared. Her name is Patty. She hangs out in the clubs downtown. She used to show up around here and act like she was everybody's best friend. It was all fun and games until her vampire sugar daddy stopped calling. Now she can't get her blood fixed and she ain't so fun no more. She's crossed the line. Only time that mouth ain't blabbing is when it's sucking vampire blood. She's gotta disappear. Do this, and we'll keep it our little secret, you hear? Alright, that's fine. I'd love to do this one myself, but I know it's silent. Just let me know when it's done.
Looky who made it back in one piece. Out in Santa Monica, kiddo. Yeah, I'm sure it was a stroll on the beach. So did you score a lot of skee-ball tickets down on the pier there? I can't imagine you did. Probably too busy getting pushed around by every vampire with a week of seniority over you, am I right? That's usually the way the story goes. Same old bullshit politics from when you were alive, huh? Don't it make you just want to rip somebody's spine out? What? You saying that's just me? Yeah, not a moment too soon, huh? You said you guys let those sabbat go too. Lions must be getting soft. How could you pass up that kind of fun? Well, he was left sireless too. I don't know, maybe that's it. Well, he's got a thing for the little guy. Someone must have put a word out. Now, here's an interesting little scenario. I'm just gonna run this by you and see what you think. What if the prince got the word out to the sabbat that you were the one to blow up their warehouse? Hey, it's a theory, man, but who else is gonna be watching you so closely, knowing where you're going and all that? I'm not saying he's working with the sabbat. I know he ain't, but he sure as hell could have put the word out there on the street where the sabbat would pick up on it. Just chew on that. How the Camarilla works, kiddo, trust me. I've been dealing with these slimy shits for a few centuries now. Politics. The stuff that makes the rich get richer, keeps the powerful in power. Look at why you're out in Santa Monica in the first place. Cause Prince LaCroix said so. You never thought you'd make it back. If Nines didn't stand up for you in the courtroom, you would have been toast right there, man. Everybody knows that. It's bullshit Camarilla law. You gotta get it approved before you sire anyone. Vampire population control, fascist crap. LaCroix wanted to look like the strong leader upholding the law. Public relations, man. Calculated risk. Ventura are born in a boardroom. When Nines called him out, LaCroix realized it was time to show a carefully measured dose of Camarilla compassion. Yeah, man. It's called kicking ass and crushing the skulls of any asshole who steps on my toes. That seems to work. People dig it. LaCroix is the boss of the Camarilla in L.A. That's it. LaCroix is the boss. That's rich. The facts are like this. The Camarilla need us to buy. Now, tell it free-living vampire. The free-living dead, kiddo. Facts are like this. Now tell him free. Kid, we lived in California. Sure thing. What's on your mind? What's up? Hey, hey, what's the word on the streets? Oh, really? The sarcophagus. Did LaCroix tell you about the Ankaran sarcophagus? Yeah, well, maybe I should fill you in on the details. That sarcophagus is bad news. Kindred around the globe have been going batshit since it was discovered. word is there's an ancient asleep in there. One of the fathers of the vampires that if you trace your lineage way back, there's a chance it'd end up with him at the root. Ancients don't just nap. They sleep whole ages away. And when they wake up, they're hungry. It's more than that. Most kindred think it's one of the signs of the end, the apocalypse. Every religion has their own version of it. Kindred call it Gehenna, and the way they tell it, it starts with the ancients' wives to devour their children. No one knows for sure, really. That's just a word that's been handed down through the ages. The Camarilla denies these ancients exist. Well, kiddo, I guess you're gonna be the one to find out. Hey, good luck. Try not to wake Grandpa Munster and kill the world, huh?
Showed up. Good. Here's what I gotta tell you. And so you know, I don't lecture, I don't rap, I'm no bureaucrat. I'm just a guy out of nowhere came to be involved in something 500 times bigger than you and me. You got a right to know the score. In Camarilla, this is the short of it. They operate a lot like a pyramid scheme. There's a bunch of these old timers at the top with God only knows what plots in mind. They lose their power, they die. They sired more to carry out their plans. Looking for a little power than those kindred sired for their own schemes, and so on and on and on. It hurts my head just thinking about the mess. What it works out to is this: only a few people at the top have any real power. Them's fighting words, newbie. But you're young and stupid, so I won't make an example out of you. See, the Camarilla claims all of us are members, even if we don't want to be. Which is, of course, the biggest little horseshit a man ever heard. I learned the way of this world during the Depression. A bunch of old rich bastards screwed the country. But did they suffer? No. The little people suffered. You can't trust the people at the top. The world would be a better place without them. All you can do is get a group of people together who aren't assholes. Find a place to put your feet up and make some examples of the quote-unquote elite to keep the rest the hell out. Everyone's an equal here. The same thing this country used to be about. That's what LA has been. An anarch-free state. The Camarilla was kicked out on their ass a long time ago. We, the anarchists, didn't want to play their politics anymore. Now LaCroix and crew pop in like they never left? Uh-uh. No goddamn way. Their laws don't apply to us. I got their meeting right here. LaCroix represents everything I hate. The Camarilla, stuck-up aristocrats, rich businessmen, crooked politicians. The only place LaCroix belongs is in an urn. Don't use me and Prince in the same sentence, Malk. I fought to keep LA free since I was embraced. Long time later, I'm one of the only ones left that hasn't bitted or switched sides. The most veteran soldier on the battlefield. Here's what I tell all the new blood. One, you get careless, that blood will make you into a monster. If you rampage around here, you get put down. Two, don't kill when you feed. No reason to. In this city, there's lots of ways to slake the beast without leaving a trail of death. Three, the Camarilla's full of shit. Four, watch your back, always. And lastly, learn how to fight. Because a speech ain't gonna save your ass when you're staring down the barrel of a shotgun. You probably already know the basics, so anything I show you is gonna take a while, and I'll need it elsewhere. You poor bastard. Listen, L.A.'s the school of hard knocks, so keep your friends close and your enemies in a barbecue pit. Once you square things with LaCroix, don't give that son of a bitch the time of night. I got my eye on you, kid.
Sabat chase you in here, Cammy? I'm Danzo. Someone talking shit about me over in that ivory tower? Who said it, huh? I'll kick their ass! Lunatic, I gave you a piece of my mind. Seeing as how you're just another D-girl for the Camarilla. Shit. No amount of good sense penetrates that white noise you knocks call a brain, does it? What? Weird you say that, yeah. You might say something is plaguing me. A plague bearer, as a matter of fact. A plague bearer's a fool that doesn't care who they feed from. Yeah, I know what you're thinking. We can't get sick, but the kind can. And kindred that feed on them start spreading disease. And that gets sick, it's an epidemic. CDC's in town as we speak. Seen old Yeller? May sound cruel, but it's necessary. If someone puts together two and two as to the real cause of an outbreak of bloodborne diseases, guess what happens? So the plague bearer's gotta be found and put down. If the Camarilla really gives a damn, they'll help us out. One of our boys' ghouls, his Paul, lives nearby in the Skyline Apartments. What a stranger is. Looked like death last time he was here. Said he didn't get bit, but maybe he's using a blind bar. Wait, if Paul's not talking, you might want to start questioning homeless Pop. So many have been dying lately that it takes a city a few days to pick up the bodies.
In other news, an apparent third victim of the Southland Slasher has arrived at the close of the Santa Monica Pier, where the body was found earlier tonight. Investigators say the scene closely mirrors those of slayings in Glendale and Long Beach. In both cases, the bodies of the victims were described as ripped, torn, bloody entrails smeared upon the walls, splatter on broken windows, feet in weird places, murder, murder, murder. Several dead at a beach house in Santa Monica tonight. Police suspect the slayings were carried out during a drug deal gone bad. They suspect this may be the work of vampires and... Hey, have you seen any vampires around here? A recent outbreak of several highly contagious diseases in downtown Los Angeles has CDC officials concerned Los Angeles may be a hot zone for a deadly new type of communicable virus. Local hospitals started seeing a dramatic increase in the amount of patients with severe respiratory illness, and many doctors say...
Yo!
Oh, for Christ's sakes. Tell Jacobson if he plans on making editor-in-chief, he's gotta start working with me. I can't keep getting him these scoops if he's gonna send high school journalists who don't know enough to wear something that would blend in. Hey, you're not from Jacobson!
Freeze!
Thank you.
Yo, Paladin.
Oh, for Christ's sakes. Tell Jacobs. Take it easy, Lois Lane. This is still a badge you're talking to. All right, look. I got you a copy of the initial report, and I can get you into the cabin, but you gotta make yourself real scarce after that. Anybody catches you, I don't know you. And no goddamn flash photography, brainchild. Hold up a sec. Hines to Marsh. Marsh, they need you up in the bridge. Over. There. The security room will be clear. Head down the stairs behind you and stay low. When you get down there, wait for me to call off the guy guarding gangway A. As soon as he leaves, get your ass moving and don't let him see you. I'll give you a couple of minutes, but don't dilly-dally. In and out, okay? Don't forget to stay out of sight. If anyone sees you, you're on your own. Take the stairs up to the security room. There'll be a computer in there. The password is Lighthouse. Lighthouse. All one word. You getting all this? Now get a move on. And don't forget to tell Jacobson I get double my usual fee for this one. Hines to Jacobson, Anderson. Hines to Anderson. Come in, Anderson.
Come check this out. I just saw a baleen whale.
Yeah?
Hop in.
Mr. LaCroix told me to keep an eye out for you, Coffee Cake. Said to send you right up. You know, I got a break in an hour, and a fresh box of Krusty Kremes in the back. How about on your way out, we, you know, I'm keeping the undesirables out and the innocent safe and secure. I'm the thin blue line that separates the crazies from the hard-working decent folks. Yep, as long as I'm around, Mr. LaCroix's got nothing to worry about.
I've said all I need to for now. I don't have time for a monologue. Give me the bullet points of what you saw. And the Ankaran sarcophagus. What did you see? Opened? Let's not jump to conclusions. Give me the manifest in your notes. I'll sort this mess later. You might have noticed when you came in the parade of malingering mollycoddles filing out. Those were the Primogen, this city's clan elders. A worrisome bunch devoted first and foremost to the security of their own skin. Which is why they were here. It seems Alistair Grout, the Malkavian Primogen, has either forgotten how to answer his phone, or is missing. The Sabbat's appearance has put the Primogen on edge. Grout's mansion is in the Hollywood Hills. I need you to pry Grout out of whatever crack he's crawled into and have him contact us. Yes, for the moment. You know, your demeanor thus far bears similar characteristics to those that rise to the top of this organization. Stay that course. Yes, about Grout. As I said, Grout is the Malkavian Primogen. His behavior and home are eccentric, to say the least. He's developed a paranoid bent lately, so you may have to check under every bed in the place for him. When we hear from Grout, you may come back. Until then. Oh, and to show my appreciation for your dedicated service to me, I have secured you a haven nearby, in the Skyline apartment building. I hope it's to your liking.
Yeah, you go right on up and see Mr. LaCroix. Cover me, Tubbs!
Must have dozed after a minute.
Hey! I know this might seem creepy and all, but please, don't blow me off, okay? Someone told me I could find you here. I mean, I've been looking all over for you since that night. Because I just wanted to... I'm in your debt. I want to help you. I owe you my life, and I feel like I need to repay you. I almost forgot. I'm Heather. Heather Poe. I'm not weirding you out or anything, am I? I can be. I know I can. I'll do everything I can for you. I got you this. I thought you might be able to use it. It can be useful to you. I'd do anything. Just tell me you'll let me help you. Let me stay with you. Make me feel this way. Really? I promise you won't regret it. Promise. I'll get you money, I'll get you things. Everything. I want to be important to you. I know where you live. I checked there first. I'll wait for you at your place. And when you do come back, I'll take care of whatever you want. I'd do anything for you.
You. What are you doing here? No. You should get out of here. This place is bad news. Pardon me.
Thank you. Often I reflect with great regret on the missed opportunity that was my infector. Had I been conscious after the attack, I could have stopped the orderlies from locking her in the roaming pen. What I would give for just one interview, a few simple questions of the plague-ridden woman who met her end that dawn. Of course, there is no guarantee she would have been any more helpful than my current crop of test subjects, mewling wretches. Few could be called enthusiastic. Given the nature of the tests, I cannot expect the same fervor from all, but a modicum of cooperation would be appreciated. Animals. The one called John went so far as to gnaw off his arm and escape into the floorboards like some feral rodent. I still hear him scurrying about at night. He must be making an atrocious mess in there. My studies proceed at a languid pace. I'm mired in a foul ennui as my wife's illness advances. My subjects grow restless without proper supervision, but I cannot pull myself back from this black depression. How many nights I've wasted now, gazing from the tower walk, pondering the frailty of existence. After decades of solitary study into this affliction, I have learned that it is by no means mine alone. Indeed, the city is home to an entire society of similarly afflicted individuals with whom I've only recently made contact. They are an understandably standoffish sort, by and large, but I have been able to confirm with them that the condition is indeed vandalism, which apparently comes in a multitude of strains, each with a spectacular set of symptoms such as invisibility and even a sort of lycanthropy. Through numerous official interactions with the governing body of this secret society, I have concluded that their fundamental understanding of the vampiric condition is woefully lacking and mired in suspicion and pseudo-religious dogma that would make a Turk balk for its strictures. Indeed, they seemed impressed with my studies and the eloquence with which I was able to present them. Apparently, the typical sufferer of my particular strain of vampirism is far from the vanguard of the King's English. So impressed were they that they even offered me an office in their government, a rather high office by the sound of things, I believe I shall accept. If nothing else, it should provide a lofty vantage point from which to observe the breadth and epidemiology of the affliction so that I may move more expeditiously toward a cure. I have accepted the role of Primogen for Clan Malkavian, the dreadfully winsome label applied to the particular strain of vampirism I suffer, so named for some supposed vampire father figure of old, more poppycock grown from a backward culture that seems interminably drawn to children's tales and the fiction of Victorian romance, when it should concern itself with the science behind their suffering. No matter. for I have taken this office for no greater reason than to advance my research. I must make mention, however, that even among my would-be peers in this governing body of vampires, the level of paranoia and superstition is frightening. Their intelligence is not the question, oh, indeed. As they courted me for this appointment, I had to suspect that their overtures were hand-tailored to what must be my obvious infatuation with reason, for the devil would do well to have such honey-tongued tempters. Even so, I could not help but notice the dressing of language these vampire leaders chose for their siren song. Whether it is born of habit, from addressing their unwashed, ill-educated subjects, or from their own deep-seated beliefs, their linguistic flourishes belie a faith in superstition over the providence of empirical reason that must be an all-pervasive theme in this society of darkest night. Damn it all, now I'm doing it too. As I expand my dealings with the vampire government, I have encountered a disturbing new symptom of this affliction. Frequently, in conversation, I will hear voices emanating from other vampires, voices that are not their own, but which seem to have insight into their lives beyond what I could gather from simple conversation. These voices seem to echo from deep within my fellow vampires, and I cannot be certain if this symptom belongs to my strain of the illness or theirs, for the voices are various and inconsistent. I dare not mention this symptom to my vampiric peers, for they have proven themselves true predators to whom I could be loath to reveal any sign of weakness. Indeed, these voices have counseled me against confessing their presence, and until I can confirm their source, I will listen. The information the voices have given me ranges from curious to frightening. The latter case is especially true of one powerful vampire whose name I shall not commit to recording in the interests of self-preservation.
Thank you.
The voices have increased in frequency and direction of late. They have begun to stay with me long after conversation has ceased and are serving as quite a distraction. I fear others are beginning to notice my preoccupation at the vampire gatherings. I am thinking again of the particular vampire of whom I spoke previously, who I dare not name for my growing fear. If the voices are to be believed, then my caution is warranted, for they speak of his blackest crimes, both past and future. More than once, I have seen the suspicion in his eyes and heard the distrust in his voice when speaking with me. The fear must register on my face, as it is all I can do in these moments to keep from crying out in chorus with the voices.
Dead? Pity it could not be by my hand. No matter. Soon your self-made kings and false prophets and all who bear the mark of the beast will be washed from the earth for the coming of the Lord. As you burn, tell them it was Grünfeldbach who sent your damned soul to that lake of fire. All agents of Satan shall return to whence they came. Let this righteous display serve as a promise to all who serve the Archfiend Lacroix. I'm coming for you, Lacroix. By the power of the Lord, I will cleanse your black soul.
okay, kid? You seem a little, off. Beg your pardon?
You went to go look into something.
What?
Say what?
Yo, that's bullshit. I don't know if you're interested in this or not, but you best not be saying this shit too loud.
I know what he's out doing, and it doesn't have anything to do with the Camarilla. They're not our only concern.
In there. Something burning? Ooh, smells like someone burnt the burgers. Sure, I'll open her up for you. Jeez, I could go for one of them double space burgers. The onions, cheese, bacon, guacamole.
The Primogens still haven't been contacted by Grout. I thought I made it clear that you are not supposed to come back until we had heard from him. Grout's dead. What? Bark. Every time I think he's lost the scent. So, Bark killed Grout to draw me out. Bark is a hunter. They stalk and kill our kind to appease their god. But like many mortals, their so-called faith is nothing but a conduit through which they quench their killing urge. Who else would have killed Grout? Look at me. Are you sure it was Nines Rodriguez? Because if it was, the consequences... Do you know where this might lead? Do you really have any idea? I'm glad you find this so amusing. I don't. And do you know why? It means... Under most circumstances, I would call a blood hunt on the murderer immediately. However, the anarchs of this city may interpret such an action to be a declaration of war. I do not want a war with them. This decision will take some time. I need to confer with the Primogen on this. In the meantime, I've come to a decision on the Ankaran sarcophagus. And I believe that for the safety of the inhabitants of this city, we need to place the sarcophagus under Camarilla protection until its contents can be confirmed. you're becoming quite indispensable to me. So, out of all my available personnel, I'm going to entrust the retrieval of the sarcophagus to you. It was quietly delivered to the Museum of Natural History a few hours ago. Let me finish. The manifest from the Dane shows there was a small box from the same dig on board, but it was listed as missing. Keep an eye open for it. It may have been overlooked. It's crucial we get the sarcophagus in our possession within the next few hours. Yes, of course. Here. I can't have one of my representatives running around ill-equipped for their task. I have methodically calculated a solution to each dilemma thrust upon our community, and I don't have the time to paint your tiny mind its place in the big picture for each and every instance. So either serve your function, or get out of my sight. Show her out.
Yeah, you go right on up and see Mr. LaCroix. That ermine gland oil and that new badge polish really makes this sucker shine.
Those who scorn me are not often given a second chance to return to my favor. Make your case quickly. Your youth and ignorance are hardly an excuse for your impudence. But I still have use of you. See that it never happens again. The only use for two olive branches is kindling. Here are the keys to the front door of the museum. The sarcophagus should be in an examination room of some sort. There's a small security staff on site, but I don't want a massacre. Mortals are just as easy to deceive as they are to kill. There is a degree of immediacy attached to this task. Work fast. And, as on the Dane, you are...